Hey guys,
I'm Skylar. I'm completely blind. I'm autistic. I have a chronic heart condition. Today, I'm going to talk to you about how God delivered me from deaflophilia. Now, before you get all, get in a twist, deaflophilia is a word that I made up. I got it from another word that I made up, devla, which means devil, plus the Greek word for love, which is philia. Like, if you've ever heard of pedophilia, necrophilia, the philia part means love of something. So devilophilia is a word that I made up. It's, in my case, it meant I was kind of obsessed with the word devil. And I don't know if you know this, but part of my autism is that I get hooked on the sounds of words, which can be really good, but it can also be really bad. And sometimes my autism, being that I'm trying to be more Christian now, I try to avoid this part of things, but sometimes my new words get intermingled with sexuality. Hence the philia part of things. So, when I was 15, I accidentally found the word devil. Now, being a Christian, I've always heard that word, but I fell in love with the word devil when I was 15, and I started getting hooked on it. Sorry, I'm laughing. It's not really funny, but and I was hooked on it from 15 to like either 19 or 20. I don't know, but yeah. For my 17th birthday, or 18th birthday, I asked for, you ready? A devil's food cake. Not a toy, not clothing, not shoes, not lipstick. No, I asked for a devil's food cake. Now, devil's food cake does taste good if you like chocolate flavored things, like I do. But the main reason I asked for devil's food cake back then is because I was a devilophiliac. I was hooked on the word devil. Well, one day, in 2010, my aunt was very sick. My mom asked me if I wanted to go to church with the people that went. I have a few cousins and stuff that are very church-going, and they were going to go to church and pray for my sick aunt, and because we didn't even know if she was going to make it or not, so... anyways, I said yes to church. Sorry, that's the dog barking in two rooms in front of ours. But I said yes to church because I wanted to pray for my sick aunt because I really liked her. I mean, so yeah. She ended up living. She's still alive to this day. 8 years later, she still lives. So, but while I was in church, somehow God ended up healing me or delivering me from devilophilia. And sometimes he uses suffering to bring us out of things. And I think he used that because that's when I had my very first vertigo spell. Excuse me. I didn't really know what it was, but it was that kind of rocking vertigo where it feels like you're on waves. Look it up if you don't know what I'm talking about. It actually does exist. But, yeah, I still have vertigo spells to this day. But, anyways. So, after the church, I came home and kind of prayed. And I asked God to forgive me for getting into devilophilia. And I got out of devilophilia. I threw everything devilophilic away, all my stuffed devils from Valentine's Day, things like that. So yeah. So when I was either 19 or 20, God delivered me from devilophilia, which is very big. Because I mean, if you go and ask my mom and ask my aunt, I was a devilophilic for a long time. From like 15, that would be like 4 years if it was 19, 5 years if it was 20. So that's a long time to be devilphilic. And now I know that that is all types of wrong. Now, I never worshipped the devil because I believed in God. I knew that no matter what word I got hooked on, I knew that if I was going to pray to anything, it was going to be Jesus. If I was going to bow down to anything, it was going to be Jesus. Period. It never crossed my mind to change gods. So I never did because I knew that was not anything to be dabbling in. Especially the devil. I mean, that's all kinds of wrong. But I am glad that God delivered me from devilophilia. I even made up a song about it. I don't know if I have time for it, but I'll try. It's to the tune of Do Remember Me, I think is the name of the song. Please, Lord, oh, please, Lord, oh, please enable me. Please, Lord, oh, please, Lord, oh, please enable me.